So let's move to the first stage of coreboot, which is called bootblock. This is where the processor jumps after the reset vector. Since it is very early boot stage, there is quite much assembly code at the beginning because the environment is quite poor. You have to execute in place from the ROM because the RAM is not ready yet. So to the main task of coreboot, we may include switching the CPU to 32-bit protected mode, and we perform some very basic initialization of the silicon, just enough to enable the debug interface and set up the temporary memory, the heap and the stack in the cache. This process of enabling temporary memory is called cache's RAM initialization. Why cache's RAM? In the very first days of the BIOS and firmware, it was mainly written in the assembly. This assembly code was responsible for early silicon setup and memory training. But after the memory was ready, only then the higher level programming language could be used to write the code. Over time, with the release of newer specifications of DDR memory, the memory initialization has become so complex that it was too difficult to write purely in assembly. That is why the CAR mode has been introduced, which lets the firmware developers use the higher-level programming language, SC, in the early boot stages when RAM is not yet ready.